guys. So I figured we'd try to do a little something different today. Gonna put our little boy to work here, hauling some equipment. From the dealer back to our farm, put our CT660 to work. This truck is configured with a I'm actually need to look it up. It is configured with 550 horsepower engine instead of the 535. Lower cheater or steerable axle there. So as we come up to the dealer here, you'll see we have quite a bit of equipment that we need to load up and ship over to our farm. So first thing first is we're gonna have to load up a tractor. Expand out our sides so we can load up the equipment. Alright, so what do we have here? We have a 26 foot 13 shank ripper. We have our 875E. We have a MacDon 45 foot FD75. Some smaller stuff, our header trailer. Unreferred Roadrunner, we got a 7130 with dual fronts. So I think what we're going to do is we're going to move our smaller Challenger over to the farm first. Hopefully everything fits on here. This is the biggest low loader trailer we have right now. That's wide enough for all of our equipment. Put on our blinkers as we roll out of here. True heavy haul fashion. Our tires should be deforming a little bit. Got pretty solid load on the trailer here. So we'll take the short route back to the farm. Blinkers on. So moving this tractor over will help us when we're moving some of the trailers. We have some equipment over here already. We have goosenecks, sea tender, and lowboy. PJ trailer with some seeds on it. Seeds and liquid fertilizer. New Dakota trailer. So we'll back this guy up and just park him there till we can load up a trailer. Probably move that grain cart next. Retract our sides, make it a little bit easier. So that's one piece of equipment down. Have to count how many more left. Can't really haul that much weight on this trailer. I'd imagine our 875E will probably max out. That or the 2730. The 2730 is about 18. Figure what the actual weight is on it. 18,000 kilograms or something like that. I'm not even sure if it will actually fit, but I guess we will see. Before we move the combine, we have to put the combine draper header on the header trailer. I actually think I'm going to try to get that 2730 on the trailer. Gonna be kind of tricky. If it doesn't fit, we'll have to drive a tractor. It's definitely gonna be close. I think it's a little too big. This is gonna have to be our last piece of equipment. We'll probably just drive this whole rig back. We'd have to get a different specialized trailer that kind of stretches out. Be able to get this grain cart out though. Okay, so that loads up no problem. And we'll have to drive that piece of equipment back on its own. know, we're on the road. We'll try to take a little different path this time. Go up an area that has some hills and stuff. So this is a JM875 grain cart, 875 bushel. You know what we probably could transport to the farm is maybe like a Kinsey. I think I'm gonna buy some Kinseys quick so we can move those. Probably the. $1,100. I wonder why this isn't locking down. Good now. We're pretty wide loads, so I need to watch out for these lights. Alright, pretty steep hill. That's pretty decent engine braking. Be nice if the game supported larger maps. Like I was working on a 16x map in 15, but Giants Editor doesn't really like it at the moment. So, but I built nice roads for it and everything. So it'd be nice to actually transport equipment longer than just, you know, a 5-minute haul. Oops, should have taken that a little bit wider. So that was a long route back to the farm. Scenic route. Should add straps to this trailer, so locks down the equipment. So we'll pull this cart off. for more. Too bad there's no traffic that comes down this road, I don't think. Go ahead and put the. So here's a Kinsey 1100. Gonna go put the MacDon in this header trailer. We can load up this combine. Perfect fit. Getting a little bit of squat in our tires now. A little bit of bulge. This is a wide load. Park it right here, then we can put the other grain cart. Pretty fun moving equipment. It's kind of a hassle when you have to move a lot of it, but really happy that they made some new scripting for these detachable low loader trailers. It makes it much easier to use. Instead of having to add collisions to the back of the trucks and then making some kind of folding or lowering animation to stabilize it so it doesn't swing around. I think next up is the Skinzy. Let's check out a road sign. Or we can haul the Macdon. Might as well get this Macdon out of here. It's a 45-foot header. Fits on the trailer pretty well. Truck pulls it pretty well. To pass this I like how the blinkers turn off after you turn. Probably park it over here so Combine can get at it, and all we have left for this truck is the Thunder Creek, which is kind of surprising of all things, of all kind of like American brands, they go with the fuel trailer. But I mean, I guess it's nice to have it. Equipment burns up fuel pretty quickly if you're playing for a couple hours. And since there's no fuel triggers and stuff like that on the farm, it's kind of a pain if you have to drive the piece of equipment to the gas station. So definitely is useful. Unlike in 15 where you kind of had like global triggers. Now we have to find a gas station. Question mark. question is, where is a gas station? Appears to be one down here. Doesn't really make sense to drive this all the way to a farm and not have it full. Love the interior on this truck though. Very nice. Alright, that's full. Buzz on back to the farm, drop this off. 4,100 in fuel. That's not bad. I'm assuming this is all diesel fuel, so buck a liter, a little over a buck a liter, which is you know, a little over $4 a gallon. So definitely remember when diesel was over $4 a gallon. Where should I park this trailer? Might as well back it in. So I think we're done with that. Oh yeah, we need a... Fortunately, we don't have a trailer to move our... massive chisel plow, or I guess combination disc ripper. Nice to have the track Kinsey's in game. A little bit bigger than my 870. Tricky to hopefully they fit. I think we'll leave that. I wonder why the engine shuts off. Alright, so it barely fits. I mean, we pretty much maxed out our trailer with the 1100. I don't know how we'd get back car. We definitely have to upgrade a trailer that can kind of stretch if we wanted to get the 1500 grain car, because that 1500 grain car is quite a bit longer than this 1100. quite centered. So that's pretty much the end of our hauling video, since we can't get our 2730 Ripper on the truck. But overall, we moved a lot of equipment, and hopefully you guys enjoyed it. So thanks for watching.